In this video, we are going to see list box. How to use list box control in our HTML and PHP. So, list box is nothing but it's a drop down box. How you can create in other languages. So, here in HTML, we create a drop down box using the select statement. So, since we are going to use HTML only, we are going to use the select statement. And if I want to select more than one from the drop-down, then you can use multi-line options. And when it is executing, you can use your control button. You can press control button and then select more than one option from the drop-down. So we are going to see how to use that. So for that, you have to use the select tag. So now already we have seen how to create radio button checkbox and all. So in the same program, we are going to use this select. So here, if you see that in which year you are, this will be displayed. After that, select statement, then you give a name for that, okay, variable name. So now, and in option, you have to mention the what will come in the drop down. So select open close opening tag and closing tag of the select. Then you if the user select this, in which variable it will be stored, which is nothing but this class one. So the user can select only one here. Now how it will be displayed in the PHP side, that we are going to see how to catch that. It's similar to the previous one. So this is what. As we have used post button, use the same here. You are in, then we call that with that variable name. It is nothing but your class one. So now I save this and then execute the program. Now, email, and strongly agree. Classroom teaching already we have seen. Let's have something else. See, if you see this, it's a drop down. The first year, second year, like this comes. I select third year and set. Okay, you are in third year. Whatever I have selected is coming here. The classroom teaching is done by Blackboard Teaching and using projector. What we have selected in our checkbox. Now, if I want to select more than one drop-down, more than one option from the drop-down, so how it can be done? So this you cannot be there because meaning also you have to see. Only you can be only one class. So we will introduce some more drop-downs. Like which subject you like. So that will be selected by, that can be selected more than once. Say your student may select digital logic, microprocessor, and object-oriented programming like that. So when you are doing, it has to be a meaningful one also. So which subject you like? You can select more than once. So how it can be done? By using the keyword called multiple. By using multiple, you are allowing the user to select more than one. So how it can be selected? By pressing the control key and then selecting. Then, since the user is sending more than one response from the HTML, it has to be cached somewhere. So here we are declaring it as an array. Okay. Here we have declared a single variable, but here we are declaring it as an array. So the user may select three options or four options, whatever it is, it will be passed as an array. And there now, since it is an array, in PHP side, you have to iterate that array and get the value which is sent by the user. So what will happen in the PHP side? We'll see that. So how it can be read? You can use for each to read the array. Already we know how to use the for each. So here, for each, then whatever the variable is, class 2. That is what we have sent in the array. So now using this, you can read. I'll explain that. See here, for each dollar post class 2. Here we have the class 2 is what passed to the PHP side. So now we iterate. So the first value will be the array name. It is nothing but which we get it through dollar post in class 2. As then you have given user variable. Okay, so one by one value will be taken and it will be placed in that. That is what here we are printing it on the screen. So the for each will iterate the values in the array one by one, and when iterating, each and every value will be placed in this single variable and that will be printed. So when it goes to the next value will be taken and from this array and it will be placed there, and so on. So this is how the for each works. So we already know that. So let us exit this. Okay. Now, and then I'm selecting third year. So here I have not given any beer. So it's coming like this. Which subject you like? So the user can select more than one. If I don't press control, I am not pressing any control. It's coming like that. Suppose I want to select more than one, I have to use the control. See, I have selected digital logic, objective, and computing test. Now I'm setting. See here, it has been caught there in PHP and it is printing. As it is iterating, treating it as an array. That array was sent, and then that array is iterated, and output you can see it here like this.